Oh my days, the fucking heat is unbearable. It's hotter than Noel Foley giving a tit wank to the sun in a sauna. Fuck. So we get to Dubai and we were shocked at how hot it was. But the heat wasn't going to stop me from getting some good deals on some games. Dubai is known as one of the richest cities in the world, so I know there has got to be some good retro games here. Man, you'd have a better chance of finding Maddie McCann than finding video games here. Am I right, Chris? Chris? Why aren't you laughing? You laugh at everything. Oh, fuck, that's right. You can't talk. As well as finding video games, one of the main reasons why we came to Dubai was to try and find a cure for the Fash Gang's lack of communication. They were the hottest hip-hop act in the world, until a corporation of cocksuckers known as AT&T decided to take away their voices. The voices that do rap music with. Now for the last year or so, they've been handicapped, and can only communicate via tweets, texts and writing. So we are hoping we can finally get the Fash Gang back up and running, and doing what they do best, and that is sick bars. This place is driving me fucking crackers, Fash mate. The heat. The lack of games. The culture shock. I'm going out of control. If I don't see one video game in the next hour, I am going to pull a terrorist attack, and make everybody on Facebook change their profile pictures to the United Arab Emirates flag out of respect and to show how gutted they are about it.
Hello, I couldn't help but listen into your conversation and...
Whoa. I was joking about the terrorist attack, mate. I wasn't really going to cause a terrorist attack here. I know you're disappointed because you wanted to join me and all, but...
I was talking about the games. I know someone that has a stack of them for sell or trade. Mostly the older stuff like Mega Drive and Super Nintendo, if you're interested.
Well, I felt like a total dick. The heat made me sound like a typical Facebook user that has no qualifications in school. But the news that this man knows somebody that has some games made me think the trip to Dubai was worth it, because I was genuinely thinking this was hell but with nice architecture and no forks going up my farter. Loving this car, mate. I'm sure I drove this on Gran Turismo 5 for the PlayStation 3. That would be the Burger King. I hope farting is legal in this country, ha 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 ha. So the Sheikh takes me to his mate's big massive fuck off a palace. I've never seen anything like it, except on such video games as Prince of Persia. I also did a trade outside of Buckingham Palace in 2013, where I got Lethal Enforcers with the gun for the Mega Drive in exchange for some shitty Amiga games. What a sucker that guy was. Whoa, this is one heck of a games room, if you don't mind me saying. And is the Turtles in Time? Mate, I got to have that game. What can I offer to get it?
I am not willing to give you that game. It was a game handed to me by my close personal friend who is a British billionaire. Do you know many billionaires in Britain?
Well, no, because I doubt they'd be living in Britain if there were billionaires. And let me tell you, if I was a billionaire, I would buy an island, and in that island, I will have Nintendo City, Sega Town, PlayStation Park, and Atari County. And in each place we'll have consoles and games for their respective lands. Man, what a dream that would be!
And you will live in this island on your own?
Well, I'll fly the lads over for a few curries and beers, with Mario Kart and Smash Bros. Sessions. But yeah, I'll pretty much be on my own. But I will get island-wide Wi-Fi installed, so I don't lose contact with the outside world, plus I can use that Wi-Fi to play Xbox and PS4 online. I had enough of the chitty chatter. I wasn't there to discuss my dreams with some rich bloke I've never met. He might steal my idea for one. I was there to get some games, especially Turtles in Time for the Super Nintendo, which was a port of the famous arcade game, and a follow-up from Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles: The Manhattan Project for the Nintendo Entertainment System. How about this? You give me Turtles in Time, and I will exchange that for a copy of WCW NWO Thunder for the PS1, which is signed by Big Vito. It doesn't get more fair than that.
No. WCW Thunder was a dreadful game. How dare you insult me with that offer?
Well, yeah, okay. You're right. WCW Thunder was fucking cack. You'd have much of a chance punching Mike Tyson in a boxing match than ever punching someone on that game, but the inlay is signed by Big Vito. That is a huge offer.
I said no. And just because you tried to haggle with me, Turtles and Time is out of bounds. Now, here is what I offer. I will give you Aladdin on the Mega Drive. What else do you have that isn't some crappy wrestling game from 1998?
Well, I have a few N64 games on me, but judging by your shelves, you already have them all complete in box. So I'm stumped. I feared that this was a complete bust. I didn't have Aladdin on the Mega Drive, so I thought I would attempt to do some chores for this shake in exchange for the game.
Okay. I have an idea. You head off to 360 Nightclub, and you bring me two white Western women back. Ones with big silicone tits and pouted lips. You bring them back here, and you get Aladdin. A deal?
It sounded easy. Picking up two women. But I didn't feel that was a good enough deal. My friends from the Fash Gang were still looking for voices, so I came up with a counteroffer. I'll get you two of the most plastic-looking white women you'd ever see, in exchange for Aladdin on the Mega Drive, and you find voices for my friends Chris Arcabusi and the Fash.
Okay, you have a deal.
Wonderful stuff, mate. Just a quick question. Why do you need two women here?
To use them as my own personal potties.
And by potties, you mean?
Taking a dump on them, peeing on them, slapping them about a little bit. They do this in exchange for gold, which is worth a lot of money.
Expelling waste inside of a toilet bowl is well and truly good, but to that on another human being is quite demented. I don't think I like Dubai that much. So I get into this 360 club alone, as the Fash Gang are going night swimming and drinking alcohol, which is a winning combination if I've ever heard one. And I begin my search for two white women with big boobs. And I was spoiled for choice. If I was a Pokemon master, I would make you Squirtle.
You fucking what?
Hey, are you Super Mario? Because you can bounce on my mushroom. With your vagina.
Do you want your fucking head kicked in?
No. Look. I'm here because the retro gaming shake or whoever that guy I just met was is looking for two buxom ladies to join him for a night of. He wants to shit and piss on you for gold.
I don't know. I have dealt with that man in the past, and he shortchanged me out of gold. The fat prick.
I know what you mean. That man refused to give me Turtles in Time on the Oh My God You Let Him Plop on You.
He offered me $500,000 in gold.
It was right there and then I had an idea. Okay. I will make sure that Shake not only pays you in full, but pays you the gold he owes you. I have my friends the Fash Gang to do that for you and also WCW NWO Thunder for the PS1 signed by Big Vito. But all you have to do is ask for a video game for the Super Nintendo called Teenage Mutant Hero Turtles Turtles in Time. And make sure it's the PAL version, as I don't have a SNES converter. Do we have a deal?
Well, it looks like I ain't getting many escorting bookings for tonight, so I might as well. I'll tell Emma I'm off.
Well, I was one step closer to finally getting Turtles in Time. I managed to convince her mate Emma, who also seemed like an escort, to join in. I handed the two ladies over to the sheikh. All I had to do now was wait and hope that I get that copy of Turtles in time, and the Fash Gang get their voices back. I waited by the pier more anxious than the time I thought my beloved NES would never get fixed after the console turned faulty on me. I was joined by my good friends the Fash Gang as I waited patiently for the return of that scat woman. I swear to fucking God, lads, if that cow doesn't arrive with Aladdin and Turtles in time, I will be fucking furious. I will stick a corkscrew so far up her cunt, I will pop her ovaries. And I will. Oh hello, did you get my games?
I really, really hate men.
Wonderful. Finally Turtles in Time is mine. If you weren't covered in poo and piss, I would hug and kiss you.
What a nasty ass bitch. Ha 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 ha.
Bussy. You're talking. Holy fuck, so am I.
This is why I need feminism. Don't you bunch of pricks have any feelings? Did you ever consider my feelings?
When it comes to games, fuck your feelings.
Ha 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 ha, get your shitty skank ass out of here, ho. The Fash Gang are back in action, bitch.
Yo, Boozy, we can finally record that follow-up to 10 years of terror. But will people be accepting of our new voices? Will we adjust to these new voices?
Well, let's release the double album first. And if people ain't digging it, then fuck it, we'll wait until we get our original voices back. No biggie, ha 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 ha. I'm giant floating balls.